And the first question we have here is, a force is given by the equation F is equal to AT plus MB small t square by capital T, where M is the mass, T is the time, and capital T is temperature. So how do you find the dimensions of A and B?
See, this is a pretty straightforward question in which we have to use the principle of dimensional homogeneity to find the dimensions of AT and MB small t square upon capital T.
Right.
So in this, we have to, first of all, we need to know the dimensions of force. So force is equal to mass into acceleration, where mass is denoted by capital M and acceleration is denoted by LT to the power of minus 2, which is meter per second square.
Right.
So first we'll use the dimensional homogeneity to find the dimension of A.
Right.
Force is equal to M LT to the power of minus 2 is equal to A into T, where T over here denotes the time.
Right. So basically, principle of homogeneity tells us that the dimensions of F, the dimensions of AT, the dimensions of MBT square by T, everything is the same.
Yep, yep.
And that's because they're being added in the same equation?
Yeah.
Okay.
Added or subtracted?
Right. Yeah.
So from here, we can get A, which is equal to M L T to the power of minus 1.
Okay.
So we can also find B similarly, which we will do.
Okay.
So M, force, which is equal to M L T to the power of minus 2 is equal to B M T square K to the power of minus 1.
Yes.
Where K denotes the temperature in this case.
Right.
So finally, by cancellation and all, we get to B. The dimension of B is L T to the power of minus 4 into K.
Right. Okay. So fine. Let's just summarize the question and the solution over here. We had this equation, and we were to find the dimensions of A and B. So we use the principle of homogeneity, which told us that each of these expressions have the same dimensions. So we found out by already known metrics like mass and acceleration that the dimensions of force was this, M into L into T power minus 2. So similarly, we found out that the dimensions of A were this and the dimensions of A were B were this.
Yep, pretty correct. The only variation that could come is that instead of force, they might give you a complicated thing.
Right.
And you have to find that using simpler equations.
Okay, okay. So we'll see that in the coming
questions. We'll see that in the coming questions.
Brilliant. So this was question number one. Okay. So today we have the second question, which is, in the relation P is equal to alpha by beta e power minus alpha z by k theta, where P is pressure, z is distance, k is Boltzmann constant, and theta is the temperature. Then what is the dimension formula of beta?
Okay, so sabse pehle in this question we have to see that we have got two unknowns, alpha and beta. So therefore we'll be needing at least two equations.
Right.
So the first equation can come using the principle of dimensional homogeneity. So according to that, pressure's dimension should be that of alpha upon beta.
Right.
And pressure is equal to force upon area equal to M L T to the power of minus 2 upon area, which is L square.
Right. So basically, we get that pressure is equal, the same dimensions of pressure is as alpha by beta, is because the dimensions of e power minus alpha z by k theta is
it is actually dimensionless. Yes.
Right. It's a number.
E to the power of anything is a number.
Okay. Okay.
So using this, we can know that alpha upon beta is equal to m l to the power of minus 1 t to the power of minus 2.
Right.
So this is the first relation that we get.
Okay.
And the second relation that we get is that in e to the power of anything, there is always a number, because we cannot raise the power of e to one dimension.
Right.
So this has to be a number over here.
Okay, okay, okay.
So therefore, whatever comes in e to the power of something, it has to be dimensionless.
Okay.
So using that, we can check that alpha z upon k theta
is dimensionless. Okay.
And is equal to m to the power of 0, l to the power of 0, t to the power of 0, k to the power of 0.
Okay.
K denotes the temperature.
Right.
And see, now the tricky part comes in, mm-hmm. that we don't know the dimension of K. Mm-hmm. Boltzmann constants, obviously no one would remember it.
Right.
So what we know is that the average translational kinetic energy for any molecule mm-hmm. is 3 by 2 K theta.
Right, exactly.
K theta, yeah. Mm-hmm. Where 3 is the F, that is the degree of freedom for any molecule. Mm-hmm. So basically this thing is equal to energy.
Okay.
It is the kinetic energy. Mm-hmm. And energy is the same as work, mm-hmm. which is equal to force into displacement.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, we can get the dimensions of energy, which is m L T to the power of minus 2 into L.
Right.
So therefore, we crack the most trickiest part of the question, if you can say.
Okay.
So that is finding the dimensions of k theta.
Mm-hmm.
So directly, I'll write it over here. Mm-hmm. Alpha into k z, which is L, is equal to
mm-hmm.
m L square T to the power of minus 2.
Yes, perfect.
So from here, we get alpha.
M into L into T power minus 2, right?
Yep, correct.
Okay.
So now it is a very, very easy question.
Yep.
You know alpha, you know the formula to get beta,
right.
using the equation 1.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll get to business over here mm-hmm. and we'll find beta.
Mm-hmm.
So beta is equal to alpha mm-hmm. upon M L to the power of minus 1, T to the power of minus 2.
Yes.
This came from the first relation that
I just wrote
a couple of seconds ago. Mm-hmm. So therefore beta is equal to m L T to the power of minus 2 upon m L to the power of minus 1 T to the power of minus 2.
Yes.
So this is equal to L square.
Right. So yeah, basically let me just summarize this question right now. We had an equation over here. P is equal to alpha by beta into e power minus alpha z by k theta. So by this equation, we had we knew the dimensions of a few parameters.
A few constants.
Exactly, like pressure and distance. But we didn't know what the dimensions of Boltzmann constant was. So fine, we figured out what to do it. So how did we figure that out? We had one equation for the dimensions of alpha by beta, which is given here. And then we also used the fact that the dimensions of the power to which E is raised is always dimensionless. So we found out that we also used the equation of the energy equation, which is 3 by 2 k theta is equal to energy, by which we found out that the dimensions of alpha were this. So once we found out the dimensions of alpha, we also had the first relation, which was alpha by beta. And now once we know the dimensions of alpha, it was very easy for us to find out the dimensions of beta, which is L square.
Yep. So the basic thing in this question is that in first look, it might look very difficult. You could samajh nahi aa raha, alpha bhi hai, beta bhi hai. And
right.
Majority logo k ka dimension pata nahi rehta.
Uh-huh.
So person might leave it. But if you proceed step by step and know what you like, use what you already know,
right.
so it becomes very easy. So this is this is actually from JE. It came one year in JE.
Okay.
So go step by step and go easily.
Right. So
and
basically what the takeaway from this question is that we shouldn't panic once we see Boltzmann constant and the dimensions of those. But we need to remember and recall equations which involve expressions like k theta.
Exactly.
Right.
And the second thing is
mm-hmm.
that e to the power of anything is a number
mm-hmm.
and the same is that with sin x, cos x, tan x, any trigonometric function
right.
or anywhere where we put in a number inside the function.
Okay.
So over there, it will always be a number. So instead of e to the power of theta, it could as well as have been sine into whatever the term is over here.
Exactly.
So that is what we have to remember.
Right. So this was question number 2 and A is the right answer. So coming to question number 3, which of the following sets have different dimensions? Option A is pressure, Young's modulus, stress. B is EMF, potential difference, electric potential. C is heat, work done, and energy. While D is dipole moment, electric flux, and electric field. Right. So how do we go about this problem?
See, first of all, this is what JE people mainly ask.
Mm-hmm.
In this question, the question is not very difficult as such,
mm-hmm.
but you need some patience and some time, because while giving the JE exam, you'll be very stressed out, and there are chances of doing mistakes in this question.
Right.
So what is required is do it slowly and do it carefully.
Okay.
So first of all, we'll check the option A.
Mm-hmm.
In this, we have to find the dimensions and we have to basically eliminate the options.
Okay.
So first, we'll check option A.
Right.
So in this, pressure, as everyone knows, is equal to force upon area.
Yes.
So now the key thing over here is don't go into finding the dimensions of pressure.
Okay.
Because we don't know the dimension. They haven't asked the dimension.
Right. It's so just waste
we just have to find the relation.
Exactly.
So, and Young's modulus, we'll come on to that later.
Uh-huh.
I'll still write it down. Yep. And stress is equal to force upon area again.
Yes.
From solids law and Hooke's law and all.
Right. So yeah. Now we have established the fact that pressure and stress are the same.
Mm-hmm.
So now we need to see. If
we need to find a formula. This my Young's modulus use ho raha hai. So everyone knows it that stress is equal to Young's modulus into strain. That is delta L upon L.
Yes.
And delta L upon L is actually dimensionless because both have the dimensions of length.
Exactly.
So from this we can come to know ki length. Sorry. Ki sigma's stress ka dimension is the same as that of Young's modulus.
Yes.
So therefore stress is equal to pressure and stress is also equal to Young's modulus.
Okay.
So therefore all the three have the same dimensions.
Right.
Okay, formula same.
Right. So basically we have eliminated that this option cannot be the right answer.
Huh.
Yes. So next let's go to the next option.
Now we'll check option number D because IIT people are pretty tricky. They'll put the correct answer in the D option so that you go to option A, B, C, D, so you'll waste some time.
Right,
so
especially in a time consuming question. Like
so what I would advise you is that in all the options, in all the questions in which you have to check every option, the order that should be followed is A, D, B and then C.
Right.
It's just a small trick in the book. Yeah.
Okay.
So we'll check option number D.
Right.
So in this dipole moment.
Mm-hmm.
Moment is equal to charge into distance equal to Q into D.
Yes.
That is QL. Q is not a basic thing, but yeah, fine. We don't need the dimensions as
yes.
such.
Uh-huh.
And we also know that electric field is the electric flux per unit area.
Okay. So basically, here itself, we can eliminate the fact that electric field and electric flux cannot have the same directions because area is not dimensionless. Can
yep.
I say that?
Yeah, that is actually what the question is
okay.
about.
Right, right.
Area is L square, so these two will obviously have some difference in dimensions.
Right, right, right.
So the correct option is B because, see, these two are different, so we don't even need to care about the third thing, that is dipole moment.
Okay.
Because these two are different, the whole thing becomes different.
Okay, brilliant. Yeah. So now we have a method where we did not even spend probably, you know, 2 minutes and found out the answer to this, whereas there was another option where we could have found the dimensions of each and every parameter which is given over here, which would consume a lot of time, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Don't go after the dimensions, just check the relations between them.
Okay, so now let's look at the other options.
Yeah, we'll check the other options
right.
as well.
Uh-huh.
So option number B is equal to potential, the first option is potential difference. Potential difference, which is the difference in potential, so its units is volts,
right?
So and different potentials units is also volt.
Mm-hmm.
Potential is also measured in volts, and therefore these two have the same dimensions, and EMF is the voltage developed by any instrument or
okay.
any device, you could say.
Right.
This is also equal to energy per unit charge, which is also measured in volts. So because all the three have the same units, uh-huh. they have the same dimensions as well.
Right. So this can't be the
yep,
right
this
option.
Is the incorrect answer.
Uh-huh.
And then we come on to option number C.
Mm-hmm.
That is work done. Energy and heat.
Yes.
So work done is equal to force into displacement.
Mm-hmm.
And energy is also the amount of work done, and heat is also measured in joules. You could see that all three of them are measured in joules,
uh-huh.
and they basically signify the same thing, that is energy. Heat
right.
is also a form of energy, as people say.
Right.
So all three of them have the same dimensions as well.
Right.
So this is also an incorrect option.
Right.
So therefore, we can also justify, like when you're giving the exam,
mm-hmm.
if in such a case, like your first option is correct, like the first thing that you check is correct, or the second thing that you check is correct, you feel a little insecure.
Right.
Ki sahi hoga, nahi hoga.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a little safe ki baki bhi check kar lena chahiye if you have the time.
Right, exactly. So what we need to remember from this question is that questions like these can be easily solved by remembering some, you know, very famous formulae
huh.
and also certain relations between a couple of other terms. For example, stress and pressure has the same dimensions. So something of that sort.
Very true. The only thing is that don't panic in the exam. Do it slowly. लोग जल्दी बाजी में करेंगे कि पहले C देख लो, B देख लो. नहीं. Don't do that. Do it systematically and slowly. And you'll get to the answer.
Right. So the correct answer for question number 3 would be option D. Dipole moment, electric flux, and electric field.
Yep. Correct.
This is question number 3. So here's question number 4. If the present units of length, time and mass, which is meters, seconds and kgs, are changed to 100 meters, 100 seconds and 1 by 10 kg, then which one of these statements is right? So can you just explain the question to me for a second?
I'll explain the question. Mm-hmm. See, right now we use 1 meter as equal to 100 centimeters, or we have a physical meter length.
Right.
Like this mass is equal to 1 meter. Mm-hmm. So what is happening in a new hypothetical world, if you would say, mm-hmm. is that meter thing is becoming 100 meters.
Okay.
That we have a scale of 100 meters. And that thing is called as one unit.
Okay, right.
So all the units are changed.
Right.
So we have to find, like, for example, velocity. Uh-huh. So basic over here is 1 meter per second. Hmm. So in that new system, that is new meter and new second, what will it be the present times? Like, it will be 10 times, 20 times, 1 upon 10 times. So that has to be correct.
Right. So what is the fastest way to solve a simple question?
See, like this, some people use different methods. Mm-hmm. But the most foolproof one is using the formula, which is taught in the tutorial.
Uh-huh.
So in that, I'll write the formula down.
Mm-hmm.
N2 is equal to N1 into M1 upon M2 to the power of X into L1 upon L2 to the power of Y and T1 upon T2 to the power of Z.
Mm-hmm.
And so on. Like, whatever units are there,
we'll just take
that.
So what is N1 and N2 over here?
See, N1 is basically 1, because we use 1 meter, 1 second and so on.
Okay.
And N2 is the times which it is multiplied in the new dimension.
Okay, right.
Like, 10 times. Hai. Mm-hmm. So, N2 agar 10 aajega, so we know that answer is A. And X, Y and Z are the powers. This is velocity. Velocity,
okay.
I'll start with the option A itself.
Right.
Velocity.
Mm-hmm.
So, dimensions are lt to the power of minus 1.
Yes.
So therefore x in this case will be 1.
Mm-hmm.
And x will be 0 because m is not there. I don't know what has happened to m with me. Y is equal to 1 and z is equal to minus 1.
So this is a simple confusion which people might go through. Velocity, we usually say it's meter per second square. So we use m and, you know.
So don't get confused over
right,
there.
Right,
between
right.
meter and mass.
Yes.
You might do that problem.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'll write it down.
Mm-hmm.
N2 is equal to 1 into M1. M1, the new units, this will be 100 meter
mm-hmm.
upon 1 meter
mm-hmm.
to the power of 1
mm-hmm.
into 100 seconds upon 1 second to the power of
1
minus 1. Because
Z is
equal to minus 1.
Yes.
So therefore, N2 is equal to, if you take it as N1,
mm-hmm.
so N1 into 100 into 1 upon 100.
Okay.
That is equal to N1.
Right.
So therefore, the new units of velocity won't change. It will be the same as that.
Right. Right. So the new unit of velocity will be 1 times the old unit of velocity. So the statement is wrong.
Yep.
Oh, okay, brilliant. So let's go to the next option.
We'll check the option D, as I said. At NJ, you should always check A, D, B, C.
Right.
Huh. So finding the units of pressure.
Uh-huh.
Pressure is equal to force upon area, that is ML to the L T to the power of minus 2
right.
upon area, which is L square.
Yes.
ML to the power of minus 1 T to the power of minus 2.
Yes.
Okay. So X is equal to 1, or rather don't calculate X, but just see it, because if you write it down, you don't have the time to write it down in exam and all.
Exactly.
Just see it and follow the procedure.
Mm-hmm.
N2 is equal to N1
mm-hmm.
into M1 upon M2. Write this down in the exam,
okay.
because you might get the answer incorrect if you do 2-3 steps in your mind.
Right,
so at least write something down.
Mm-hmm.
L1 upon L2 to the power of minus 1 and what do you call it? T. Yep. T1 upon T2 to the power of minus 2.
Yes.
N1 into M1 is 1 upon 10 kg upon 1 kg.
Yes. So the rest of them will be 100 and 100.
Yep.
Right.
100 meter.
Yes. By 1 meter.
By 1 meter. And to the power of minus 1.
Mm-hmm.
And 100 seconds.
By 1 second.
By 1 second. So you can see that this will be a number because this meter and the second gets cancelled and everything.
Right.
To the power of minus 2.
Yes.
So this will come out to be n1 into 1 upon 10 into 1 upon 100 into 1 upon
100 square
equal to 10 to the power of minus 7 into n1. So this option is also incorrect because it is written as 10 to the power of minus 3.
Okay.
So now we'll check option number B. Force is equal to MLT to the power of minus 2. Everyone remembers this by now at least. So you don't have to use any other formula.
Right.
N2 is equal to N1 into M1 upon M2 to the power of 1. L1 upon L2 to the power of 1.
So basically, like if we keep practicing questions, we'll obviously remember the dimensions of force, which is very
force is pretty basic. Right. And if you do a lot of questions, you don't even need to write all this down.
Right.
You can do it in one step. You can skip a step or something.
So practice is
do a lot of questions of this sort because they seem very confusing in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
1 upon 10 kg upon 1 kg. 100 meters. 1 meter.
Power minus 2. Okay.
Equal to N1 upon 1000. Which is correct.
Right. So basically, again, let's recap this question. So we had to find out the dimensions of the new dimensions of velocity, force, energy, or pressure as to fit into a true statement of the four options.
The new units, basically.
Exactly. So we had we had the initial units, which were 1 meter, 1 second, 1 kg, which were changed to 100 meter, 100 seconds, and 1 by 10 kg. So we had to find the new units in the new set of dimensions.
New dimensions.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we found out that A was the wrong answer. And the key to this question, can I say that...
Is this formula?
Yes. So we used this formula in all the three options, which first we went into A, we found out that is the wrong answer. We went into D, and then the pressure was 10 power minus 7 times, but then it was written that it was 10 power 3 in the option. So again, this was another wrong option. And then we went to B, and then we found out that it was indeed N1 by 1000, which was exactly what is given in the solution. So option B is the right answer for this question.
Yep, very true. Normally the questions which come is that they will ask you to convert MKS system into CGS system, or they would ask something which you know, like CGS into foot pound something. But this is the most general form of it. If you can do this, you can do any other question. So do try to practice as many questions of this type that you can.
Right.
And you'll be good to go.
Exactly. So you, by practice we get speed, and by this formula also we get more speed, right?
Ek cheez dhyan rakhna isme, that M1 or M2 ka sahi likhna, like don't write M1 like M2 in place of M1.
Right.
That is a mistake that can happen.
Yes.
If you don't practice enough.
Yes. So this is question number 4.